Hey, good evening, Royals fans. As I'm still here at the stadium after covering the Royals for the great Flyers, Nitty Gritty, Yoris Wolak, and Jamie Bascal, that I'm always eternally grateful to be able to cover, and the great running Royals for allowing me to cover their wonderful game. This was a very, very fun, enticing game to watch the entire game, that unfortunately we did not get the result that we wanted in a 2-1 OT loss, but there is a lot of good for our Reading Royals to take from this game. Like, for example, Jacob Pritchard continuing to look like an absolute stud out there and stepping up his game even more, obviously, since coming out, Josh Lindquist going out last week after his fight. He has really stepped up his game big time. And head coach Kirk McDonald did point out how he was very good up in Boston in college, of course. And that is not just obviously a fluke. You have to play for a school like that and have some success, even though you have McCarr and Leonard and others. You have to be able to produce yourself and play at a great key high level. And he did that there, and he's doing that here now. Jacob Pritchard is a very impressive guy to watch. And then Morrison had his moments in his second game. Again, I think a better game last night in a losing effort that the Royals overall did not have a good game. Morrison looked better last night. But in this game, the overall team, it was a nice push, a nice intensity. Overall good play from both clubs, but I think the Royals, like Kirk McDonald said in the post game, and also if you enjoy the kind of, please subscribe here, NF Flyers Nitty Gritty, on the subscribe button down below, the easy to use widget at the end. But like Kirk McDonald talked about, this is a game that the Royals outchanced them and honestly did better in mostly all facets of the game. It's just sometimes that sports for you, you just end up getting an L, even though you do everything right and you play a very good game. And Kirill Ustamenko continues to get more and more comfortable, as obviously he's coming off a hip surgery. Now he's getting more and more reps. Only played 2 games last year in Belarus and then only a handful before getting back-to-back tilts, obviously, this weekend. And he looked good in those games, looking like the old Usti, as Kirk McDonald also said, the Usti we all know, in the postgame. And he is playing just as we would expect now, coming down and now getting reps. All it is with goaltenders is if you don't get the reps, especially they're coming off of a hip surgery, which affects your horizontal movement big time, I don't expect the guy to look very sharp like he didn't up until this weekend when he finally was able to get put in, obviously, in a game on yesterday, that he looked sharp in and then looked even sharper. This was by far his best game of this calendar season for Kirill Ustamenko. And also, shout out to former Royal Pat Nagel. The Lehigh Valley Phantoms also lost in OT. We both lost to Toronto affiliates in OT. Their goal was Josh Hosang. Ours was, of course, to McKenna, who might end up apparently getting a call-up with something I've been hearing to get called up potentially to the Marlies or something there from his good play with the Norfolk Admirals. But this was really a goaltender battle that Kirill Ustamenko stood on his head. Cormier saved the day, just as Usti did on a couple saves, particularly the breakaway in the second. But Cormier really, honestly, was the difference in this game, in my opinion, when it came to the Royals being able to get a regulation win. He made some saves that he was just sprawling out there, really getting his feet across quickly and really moving horizontally really well in this game. As obviously for him, he didn't get a lot of reps, as the starter for the Norfolk Admirals is up on the Toronto Marlies right now. So now Cormier is able to get a bunch of reps and get a back-to-back, just like Kirill, and just like Kirill looked good in the back-to-back, where I would say in this game, both goalies looked exactly great, and it's just Cormier was able to get the W because it's one of those games that once you get to a 3-on-3 OT, it's basically just whoever can get that nice opportunity. I kind of got one down here if I can turn the down on the other end of the ice, basically, on the side there, and was able to fire one home past Ustamenko. He didn't have any chance on whatsoever. And then the first goal of the game, the first 21 seconds, he had absolutely no chance to get that one. His power was just set up perfectly in the slot right in front, and he didn't have any opportunity to get that. But after that first 21 seconds, the Royals played a freaking hell of a game. Almost accidentally pulled a Kirk McDonald there and said something they're not supposed to say. They played a freaking hell of a game, and it just didn't get the result you want. And that happens in sport. You just got to get through it. You got to push through and come back tomorrow and play the same great style and very enticing is the word I was looking for, style that they played tonight that was fun to watch. And there should be a W against a very familiar, of course, Norfolk Admirals team that the Reading Royals take on tomorrow. So this has been a reaction to the 2-1 OT loss, a loss that I think there's a lot more good to take from, which is really not much bad in this game, honestly, at all, minus that first 21 seconds. This was just one of those games you happen to just lose, even though you played a good hockey game, and that happens in sports, and it's about coming out tomorrow and pouncing on those Norfolk Admirals to get the W. Peace out, everybody, and go Royals. This has been the latest edition of the Royal Take. I'm Joe Bora from Sports Fanatic News and the great Flyers Nitty Gritty. Follow here and at Flyers Nitty Gritty. We appreciate you all, and peace out.